What if I told you that DICE have created one of the best, yet the worst, Star Wars game? And the game I'm talking about is Star Wars Battlefront 2. And I'll explain my reasoning with this. The multiple classes, fine with. You know, you have the assault, the heavy, the officer, I can't remember what it is. And then the sniper, the specialist, I think it is. It's all great and good. The problem with them is the assault. Barely any health. And weapons suck. The heavy, the heavy gunner, whatever you want to call it, the second one, the LMGs, hard hitting, shields are powerful, sentry guns are amazing, impact grenades are pretty good, 150 health, and what else? Oh yeah, everyone plays them in multiplayer. If they're not a sniper, they're probably going to be a heavy gunner. Specialist, not specialist, the officer. Pistols. Everyone uses 3-round burst, fast firing.
May the force be with you, always.
Pretty much useless as a class, honestly, besides the, what do you call it? The infantry turret. they have the circle that buffs everyone, and they have the shot grenade, I believe, or the stun grenade specialist, or the sniper class. One-shot snipers, or a one-shot sniper that everyone uses. Haven't seen anything else been used.
Grenade.
It's okay. Yeah, it's the I think it's the one that splits and stuns. And this is without star cards or whatever you want to call them. Abilities, whatever. They have the goggles, which is amazing. Not complaining at all about them. And they have the fast-firing 3-round burst scanner disruptor ability, which is their L1R1. Okay. Yeah, I'm fine with that. You know, it gives them a temporary time to rush in, be damaging. Except they never use it. 90% of... You know what? I'll go as far as to say... And if... Out of all of the matches, half of them are specialists, or snipers, whatever you want to call them. I'm just going to call them snipers. And the other half are the heavy gunners. I rarely see anyone playing as the officer or the assault. And as much as I enjoy Battlefront 2, they've hit the nail on a piece of metal and the nail just curved to the side. Looks great. Have maps that are decent. You can't play any good maps offline. The guns are unbalanced, and honestly, I'd rather them have given everyone the same amount of health and go the battlefield route or the old Battlefront route. I'm talking about the original Star Wars Battlefront 1 or 2. I'm actually looking to pick up 2 because I haven't actually played the original Star Wars Battlefront 2, but we'll talk about that later. And, you know, give, you know, instead of having the whole heat up, that your gun heats up, it has an actual ammo count that you reload, because, you know, these are guns, not energy weapon. And it just doesn't seem to flow right with, honestly, than it being a Star Wars game. The story, it's generic Star Wars, I'm not gonna lie. And this is coming from a diehard Star Wars fan. And I can already tell you, fuck Disney and anything they've done with the Star Wars series. Kostoff, Rey, Kylo, Finn, Captain Phasma, any of that bullshit. And stick with the original six, and stick with that. And the EU, you know, how Disney said the extended universe is no longer canon.
Skywalker,
Disney doesn't
by.
Understand that the extended universe has to be canon for the series to be canon. But, you know, Disney thinks they know best, and whatever. Oh, just look at the Han Solo movie. See how well that did. And, besides me ranting about Disney, the game, graphically pleasing, customization, terrible.
Go, go!
I'd rather buy Overwatch loot boxes. At least that has more variety than the... You know what? I'm not even going to talk about customization. Because there isn't any, let's be honest. The only customization is on the armor, and that changes color, and it might add two markings to it, or something like that. When I play a Star Wars game, and it gives me the option to be playing as, you know, the Rebels and the Empire, or the 501st or whatever battalion for the clones and the droids, and the terrible First Order and the Resistance. I expect to be able to choose which ones I can play, and you know, I can, with arcade mode. If I jump into normal multiplayer, I have not played a single match where I am a addict. I have not played a single match where I have been a clone trooper or a droid. And honestly, that is my biggest turnoff about Battlefront 2. I would sincerely and heavily recommend scrapping everything they have done with these Battlefronts and just take from the old system, you know, the PS2, with Star Wars Battlefront, Star Wars Battlefront 2, the originals, you know, LucasArts and all them. I know LucasArts was part of the first two, these two. But they have the right engine, the Frostbite engine, they have the right graphics, they have the right idea. They fucked it up. Give us an ammo count and not heat overload or whatever with our gun. Make everyone the same health.
Keep watching the traps, okay?
One class. Or, you know what? No. Go with, like, the, Star Wars Battlefront, Clone Troopers, story mode, whatever, where you had the... if you played as a Separatist, you had the Droidicas. Those would be amazing and fun to see in multiplayer. The Super Battle Droids that you could choose from. Just the normal Battle Droids. You know, the Roger Droids. With the E5 or whatever. They did good with the guns. They screwed up on how they use them, though. With overheating, putting characters behind a score wall before you can play them, and even if you have said score, you might not ever be able to play as the character that you really want to, because someone else is probably playing as characters, or there's too many heroes on the field as is. So you're limited to playing other modes that are less fun and more try-hardy, And
go.
If you recall back to my Battlefront, Star Wars Battlefront 2 beta videos, I said I love the game, and I do. But at the same time, I'm hating it because there is nothing in here that is like the beta. And they recently added General Grievous. Great. They brought back Palpatine 2 months ago, I think. He was gone for most of the game life. Honestly, I think the game's dead now. And, you know, EA, you want to reach out to me or anything? Hint, hint, DICE, you know, hit me up. I'm cool with that. I want to see the Star Wars series better. I want to see it like the old Battlefronts. Not pathetic. Not paywall. Not DLC. None of this, you know. Ooh, I can, you know what? Emotes? Great. Weapons? Fine. But don't make it to where some classes are better than others. Go with Gilgath, not pussy out and cater to everyone. You know, it's the only Star Wars audience, as far as I know, but Star Wars Battlefront games, new ones. And you know what, that's great. You know, I'm glad to see that the first Battlefront did well, and personally, I felt it was an amazing game, but it was also terrible, just like this one. But the first one is amazingly better. You know, I'd rather deal with people having guns that are behind DLC and doing all this stuff than constantly dying to just corner peekers using third person. And I understand that a lot of people enjoy third person in the original Battlefront. And that worked as a single player game. But as a online multiplayer game, it's cheating. Let's be honest. Like, it's cheating. It's like Uncharted hiding behind a wall. You know? It's not skill, it's waiting. Waiting. It's like third person games in PUBG. Or if Blackout on Black Ops 4 had third person. There's not any skill there, it's just waiting, and then, oh hey, I popped around the corner because I already had my gun locked onto your head with aim assist and everything. You're dead. And guess what? The next person that does it, they're dead and dead and dead until somebody finally realizes, hey, there's this guy there. I need to throw a grenade. Nope, a grenade doesn't matter. Because, you know, if it's not an impact, I can run away and then roll. And it does no damage to me, and, you know, there's no risk to me. Honestly, if you are going to make any multiplayer games that are based on a franchise as like Star Wars, or as in, or like Star Wars, make them first person. And, you know what, with the heroes being third person, fine. No, I'm cool with that, but if you're on the ground, shooting DC-15s, the DC-15Ls, or DL-15s, whatever, I can't remember. The LMG looking one for the specialist, not specialist, the heavy gunner, for the clone. You know, I want to be able to aim down sight, not zoom in. Like, that is just so astronomically dumb. What is wrong with you? Why would you think that's a good idea? And the guns you can aim down sight with? It's got a green, hollow, whatever you want to call it, and it's terrible. You know, I can't even set up my LMG to aim accurately. I have to crouch down or pray my shot to it. By that time, I'd rather have been sniped in the head and killed with one shot in the body. Or, you know, someone ran around a corner in the third person, waited for me to start rushing. Killed me. And you know, you can say, oh, you have the same advantage as them. But it's all about who makes the first move, and you can't win a game if you don't move. Like, I really sincerely believe DICE have hit the head of Star Wars and gave it a concussion that's deadly. If Star Wars Battlefront 2 hasn't killed the series, either the next game is going to revive it, or it's going to end it if they make another one. And they really need to listen and focus on this, like they will with Battlefield 5. Because, you know, if we're just now getting General Grievous for the clones, and this is another thing with the heroes, I don't want to see other heroes from other eras in the clone era. I don't want to see Han Solo, Luke Skywalker, Leia Organa in the Clone Wars. I want to see Darth Maul, Obi-Wan Kenobi, Anakin Skywalker. You know what, here, let me just list off some, you know, people they could throw in for Clone Wars and make it Clone Wars specific. Anakin Skywalker for hero, and there's three heroes already. Anakin Skywalker, Obi-Wan Kenobi, and honestly, if you want to take from the animated series, Ahsoka Tano. Or if you want to do just one lightsaber, I do Anakin Skywalker. If you want to do a gun, Commander Rex, or Commander Cody. Personally, I would prefer Rex with his dual-wielding DC DC-15As. I'm not sure. I don't know. The pistols. You see me use it in one of the videos. And, okay, let's see. Anakin, Rex. Lightsaber, shooter. Huh. I mean, they could do Plo Koon, they could do Bree, they could do Cody, they could do Obi-Wan. There's just too many characters, but they've shown in all the wrong ones. Villains, they have Maul, great. Phantom Menace works, but who's his counterpart? Doesn't make sense. Grievous, who's his counter? And by counter, I mean who's his opposite, like, hero. Grievous has lightsabers. Well, you also have Darth Maul, Vader, Kylo Ren, as much as I hate him. Because, you know, he's just a wine little brat, and I don't know what would happen. And it's just... they've done this so wrong. You know, I don't want to see Boba Fett with the clones, because he's a clone. They've just been aged very rapidly. You know, he's Jango's son, technically. Yeah, technically he's Jango's son. But where's Jango? That should have been the one they put in instead of Boba Fett. And there's just so many things wrong with this game. From lack of content updates, lack of communication to us as the community. Paywalls that people complain about but aren't there anymore.
Your defeat is at hand.
Customization they claim to have, but it's not there. Honestly, I want to just go out and make my own Star Wars game. That's how compelling this game is, and how bad it is to me. That I'd rather go out, risk everything I own and live for, create a better game. Because as a AAA title company, this is pathetic. This is a pathetic excuse for a game. And this is coming from someone who enjoys No Man's Sky as much as everyone in the world hates it. This is a pathetic excuse for a Star Wars game. I'm gonna leave it at that since I've already talked for 20 minutes. 21 minutes. I just want everyone to think about what I've said, as awkward as my commentary is probably going to be. This is also recorded at 5 a.m. I haven't gone to bed yet. I like work. But this is just how I feel. They have something great, and they completely messed it up. It's like Daisy on Xbox One. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. You see me out in the gaming world, on the front lines, or anything, or Battlefield. If for some reason I decide to play Battlefront 2 online, shoot me a message saying, hey, good video, or hey, try this, or anything like that. I'll be willing to give it a shot. But, children, think about what I said. Like, comment, subscribe, all that jazz, and, yeah. Burn it all. See you later, troops.
The dark shadow is powerful. You are confused. No matter. Scream if you wish. Use for you.
Watch for intruders.
There are great rewards in victory. Experience power! Pity, such pity.